Hey guys, what's up? UTS Productions here, back for another LEGO Star Wars video. And today we're going to be going through my entry for G-Bricks' mock contest. Now the main rules were it basically had to build after a certain date, but aside from that, I'm pretty sure the rules were go big or small or whatever you want really. I have, however, decided to go for a small 16 by 32 base plate size mock, just because I really wanted to focus on a specific scene and I had this cool idea for something smaller that you could sort of have like a 360 degree view of, and I think it's turned out really, really well. I've chosen to do a scene from the Battle of Geonosis. Now, it's not necessarily one that is taken straight from the film. It is a little bit sort of Geonosis inspired. It's pretty much just like the planet, and then there's like a little outpost inside as well, which I thought was quite cool. And we've got some really cool minifigures, and they are all official LEGO minifigures, but on one of them, I believe it's just the one of them, I have actually sort of created a custom minifigure out of a few different parts of a clone trooper. I think you guys will really, really enjoy this, and I just want to say before we get straight into the video that if you guys are not already subscribed to the channel, it'd be a massive help, and it'd be really great if you guys could go check the channel out, see if it's worth subscribing. Also, it means you won't be missing those updates for future videos and live streams, which we do quite often, well, I do quite often over here on the channel, and I'm going to be doing a lot more over the next month or two as the new LEGO sets coming out for 2021 Summer Wave. Anyway guys, like, comment, subscribe, all of that good stuff. Let's get straight on into the video. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a 360 degree walkthrough of this little mock first off, and then we will get into some pictures and a few little video shots where the mock contest sort of section of the video will come in. And then we'll head over to the outro, so let's get into it. So as you guys can see on the back right here, we have the big mountain corner, and this really was to signify just like a big Geonosian mountain going off into the distance. And then on the front here we have a small spire. Now I do have like limited pieces as well, so this is pretty much sort of what I could come up with on hand. I wanted to do some other like smaller style designs, but I just didn't have the dark orange headlight bricks to sort of finish that section, finish those little bits off to make it look flush. I then also at the back did add like a little mound that you can see here. And what I might do in a second is take all the minifigs off, but before I do so, I do want to sort of just tell you guys a little bit about what's going on here. So the scene I have portrayed is a Jedi and a commander against a couple of flying Geonosian warriors here, and they're sort of coming in from different angles. And then we have a Geonosian in the back corner here who is sort of running off because he sees the Jedi that is like attacking. And as you can see around the back here, there is a small like command outpost in the back, which we'll get to in a minute. But the idea is that obviously the Jedi are essentially, Jedi and clone troops are pressing onto this outpost, and they're trying to get to this outpost because there's some important people in there, and these guys are sort of defending it, and this guy is running off back to the outpost to essentially tell the commanders that there is going to be a Jedi attack. I'm probably going to get onto the minifigures as a whole in a minute because I know that you can't really see them all too well. My camera doesn't like to focus sometimes. But that's pretty much it. Then we just have a couple of crates here, which was a simple design that I actually got from my last mock. It was my last mini scale size mock, done on the same size base plate as this, which was a portion of Fort Anaxis, which I'll link up in the eye as well. May as well. But yeah, this is pretty much the outside. Also, we have a clone trooper that is sort of just deceased. He's been shot down and just splattered on the floor, basically. So then I shall now move around to the outpost here. So as you can see in the outpost here, we basically have a holo table with Emperor Palpatine in the hologram, and Count Dooku and Poggle the Lesser are having a bit of a meeting with him, discussing how they're going to proceed on their attacking. And then we have like a cool little yellow hanging light, because I know on Geonosis they have like those yellowy lights, especially in the droid factories, and this could be like the entrance essentially to a small droid factory or confinery or something. I was just going for that sort of vibe there. So there's really not all too much in here. It's just sort of plated off. I wanted to do some different designs of grey plating and a bit of like Gene Ocean splatters of dirt in there. There's only just one or two tiles, but I was really, really happy with how this rock work came out. You can't actually see just how detailed it is, but I've also done a lot of like inverted slopes, and I've used that technique with the blue Technic pins where you can put things upside down and stuff. And I really wanted to sort of show that it was just like a rugged cave, so all of that the Gene Ocean mountain sort of was coming through from the outside in. You get me? So it's just sort of been carved out enough, because they are meant to be like catacombs and that kind of thing. So that is the inside, and then moving back around to the outside now, I just wanted to show you guys a bit more of the plating, essentially. So I was really, really happy with how this came out. A lot of people go for normally one or two techniques these days, and it's normally always either loads and loads of plate, just like 1x2s, 1x3s, 1x1s, corners, and just doing that. Or they go for like a straight tile look kind of thing. And I think I really enjoyed this tile look, because I didn't want to put too much terrain on this, because where it is quite a small like hypermock, I don't think the terrain would really differ that much in this small of space, which exactly is why I also didn't want to add too many more spires in there as well. I just wanted to do enough that it could create like a really cool scene without overcrowding it, which is why I also didn't put like any more figs in. I just wanted to really show different techniques and detail and stuff. So like with the positioning, like minifig placement, so we've got air troopers, we've got ground troopers, and the way that the minifigures are placed. So what I've actually done with this clone trooper, which was quite cool, is I've detached the legs apart, as you can see, and I've changed out his waist piece for a black 1x2 plate, so it looks like his waist belt still. And then if you place it in the correct way, then it looks like he's sort of attached but detached. And then another thing which I really thought was quite a cool idea, I haven't actually seen people do this before. Now, normally what people do is they completely take these arms out and they put like blue tack or something like there. But I found that if you sort of just get like the ball bit that goes inside of the clone trooper torso, and you just sort of press it in sideways just enough, you can actually get it to hold in there on its own, and it looks really good. And I've always been a bit worried myself about putting like blue tack and stuff inside of the torsos in case you couldn't get it back out. So that's another really nice technique. And then I just laid the gun next to him, sort of just like splayed out on the ground. I really wanted to show you guys how to incorporate just enough plate and tile together, not making it look too much, because I found that tricky myself, like putting the same tiles next to each other and the same size plates next to each other, that kind of thing. Also with Geonosis, where it is one of those planets where it's majority just one colour, I did also want to try and just add some little points of accentuation in there, but nothing too much, which is why I've gone for the medium nougat colour, which I know a lot of people do, but it really, really worked well here. I just wanted to add in enough so it looked like it was sort of trailing through the mock this way, and then there's a little bit on the slope at the back. So what I'll do is I'll get these minifigures off and then show you guys very quickly. So as you guys can see, there's just a bit of the medium nougat in there, and it just sort of carries across, just as if it's been swept across the land, really. I would say the last point of detail for this mock is along the front here. I have tried to sort of texture in along here. Now, I know that I could have gone back and done this a little bit better, but I wanted to try a few different techniques. I wanted to try doing it with plate, sort of try and like merge it in there. And then I also like got halfway through and I thought, let's give this cheese slope type thing a go, because I've seen some people doing it recently and it does look really good when done carefully and properly. So I did give it a go. This is my first ever time doing it, and I would say it's not incredible, but I think it has worked out satisfactory. Like, I know that I could have done better. I do think also, I would say to anyone doing this in the future, don't try both, because although I think it looks passable here, I do think that it would look so much better if it was just continuously done like that the whole way along. So as you can see, this is all of the minifigures that I used in the mock. Now, on the right hand side, you will see the dark side, essentially, and on the left, the light side. So this is the Count Dooku minifigure, and a lot of people slate this minifigure, but I actually think this is quite a cool minifigure. And I know that mostly people just like slate the face, but I find it quite a cool face. I mean, it definitely represents him in the Clone Wars, because in his Clone Wars style face, he has a very long, prominent face. And I didn't want to use the lightsaber because where they're only having a meeting, I thought there was no point actually having the lightsaber on. You know, they're just sort of in the meeting room. So the next thing we have is the Poggle the Lesser minifigure. Now, the reason why Poggle the Lesser doesn't have his wings on is for two main reasons. One main reason is, again, you don't really need to have the wings open and on whilst he's in that small room. And the other thing was that the wings, for some, I don't know if anyone else finds this, but with the Poggle the Lesser minifigure, when you have the wings on, like, it sort of pushes the head up, and then the head's really loose. So I actually find this figure is better without the wings. Then we have a ground Geonosian trooper who just has that kind of like comms thing, which is a pretty simple build. It's basically one of those like communication pad tiles with a minifig hand on it. So it's just a simple one. And then we have two more Geonosian troopers, but these guys both have the special blasters and the wings. Exactly the same trooper apart from that. Moving on to the light side with the minifigures, we have our Ki-Adi Mundi figure here, who I recently got in the Jedi and Clone Trooper Battle Pack. I think he's actually a really great minifigure. I really enjoy his print. I'm very happy that they updated him. Yeah, so we've got Ki-Adi Mundi here, and in the scenes before, you would have seen he was actually using the Force on the other trooper. He's kind of stood like that. I kind of forgot to mention that before. Next up, I shall leave the other one till last. We have our ARF trooper, who is actually a really cool figure. These have been one of my favourite figures out of all the clones for ages now. I think it's just that head mould is so cool, and I had to give him the custom blaster, obviously. Last but not least, we have our Commander minifigure. Now, I thought this was a really cool mix-up, and I genuinely have never seen someone do this before. So what I did is I got Commander Fox here, as you can see, and I've got his torso, arms, and his helmet. And what I've done is I've actually mixed him with the ARC Trooper from the, I believe it was the ARC Trooper Battle Pack or something like that. It was the one you got like the Rancor Battalion ARC Trooper and all that as well. So what I did is I basically just gave him the custom legs because they're actually the same color as the arms. And I also gave him the waist capes as well because I just thought that added a really nice bit of detail. And I think these are some of the only guns in LEGO, in like official LEGO, that you don't need like official guns to top. Like these classic dual pistols are just such a good mold, and I can't believe that they stopped making them because they were honestly just perfect. Like they're so sick, and they actually go for like quite a pretty penny now on the secondhand market. So that is the last minifigure. That covers all of the minifigures, and I'll just go through the crates quickly as well. So again, we have this crate which is made of a couple of circle plates and tiles to top it off, and then just some grill pieces that are kind of snotly stuck into each end, and that's on both of these. Makes for a really nice Star Wars looking crate. And then the last one is the official LEGO one, which just has all of the Star Wars writing and stuff on it, basically. Really cool crate. I have no idea how much it's worth, but that is the whole mock, guys. So I think we're going to move over to the outro now. So I really hope you all enjoyed this mock. It was really, really fun to make, and I really want to do more stuff like this in the future. Obviously, let me know what your thoughts and opinions are in the comments section down below, where I could have improved on any other minifigures you would have liked to have seen, or just future ideas. I'd love to see what you guys have in store for me. Anyway, that's going to be all for this week's video. Obviously, don't forget once again to like, comment and subscribe to the video if you did enjoy it, and I'll be back very soon, hopefully, with another video. Stay safe, peace out.